welcome to my YouTube channel VK Classes. Today we'll discuss chapter number 3, metals and non-metals, as the most important question answers and as well as the passing package. So let's begin question number 1. Name the metals melt at body temperature among gallium, magnesium, cesium and aluminium. You know it here, gallium and cesium are melt at body temperature. Question number 2. Name two metals which reacts with dilute nitric acid to evolve hydrogen gas. Here students, magnesium and magnesium are the two metals which reacts with dilute nitric acid to release hydrogen gas. This question is basically asked on theme of what happens when metal reacts with acid. You know it, the metal reacts with acid, sulfuric acid and HCl releases hydrogen gas, but not with all other metals, not react with nitric acid. Why? Because nitric acid is the best oxidant agent which itself reduces hydrogen from its compound and release out water. But there are the two metals which is manganese and magnesium react with very dilute nitric acid and to release hydrogen gas. So remember these two metals which reacts with dilute nitric acid is important question student. Question number 3. Arrange the following metals in decreasing order of their reactivity. You studied this question asked based on reactivity series of the metal. So sodium, potassium, lead, copper, iron and silver is asked. So let us arrange in decreasing order. Decreasing order means we have to arrange from high to low. So very high reactive series is element comes potassium, then after sodium, iron, lead, copper and last silver will come. So here highest reactivity series element comes potassium and lowest is comes silver. So the element goes from high to low, which is called decreasing order. Next, question number 4. Name the lustrous non-metal. Non-metal they asked students. So lustrous non-metal is iodine. Next question. Question number 5. Name the metal which forms amphoteric oxide. It is very important. The zinc and aluminium oxides are called amphoteric oxide because the oxide which releases with both acid and bases. Question number 6. How do metals and non-metals combine? You know it, very important question students. Metal and non-metals combines by the transfer of electrons from metal to non-metals which forms under ionic bond. You know it, metal and non-metals will gain and receive the electrons of their outermost cells and to form compounds. So the metal and non-metal combines by sharing of their outermost orbits electrons under ionic bonds. Okay, next question. Question number 7. Name a solvent which electrovalent compounds are soluble, a solvent in which they are insoluble. Important question students. Here students, you know it, under ionic compounds. Which are ionic compounds? The electrovalent compound which formed the compounds by sharing their ions are called electrovalent compound. For example, common salt NaCl is a electrovalent compound which is the water is the most solvent which makes electrovalent compounds are soluble. And inorganic it is. Organic compounds which are called kerosene, benzene, petrol, which are organic or non-polar, are the solvent which cannot insoluble by electrovalent compounds. It means very in simple words students, water is also called universal solvent. So including maximum solutes are going to dissolve, one of them electrovalent compounds which also dissolve in water. So water forms by their polar region and makes the compound soluble. But the kerosene, benzene and petrol, which are organic solvents, they are insoluble with electrovalent compounds. Understood? Okay. Next question. Question number 9. Name one metal which reacts neither with cold water or nor with hot water, but reacts with only steam to produce hydrogen gas. See, interesting question it is also. Name one metal that is neither react with cold water, hot water, but only it reacts with steam. That you know it, iron. Iron is the metal, students, does not react with cold water if you kept for long time. Even if you dipped the iron metal into hot water, no reaction shows. But you know, when the steam is passed through iron, there is liberation of hydrogen gas. So certain metals, what happens when metal reacts with water? Some metals reacts with cold water vigorously on the spot. Some metal reacts with slowly, produces hydrogen gas as bubbles around us, for example zinc granules and all, students. Yes, and some metal reacts with warm water. Some elements will not react even after cold hot water, but they react in the form of water in its in steam. So iron is an example for that. Next question. Question number 10. A piece of granulated zinc was dropped in a copper sulfate solution. After some time, the color of the solution changed from blue to colorless. Why? You know it, very important question answer. On the basis of displacement reaction as well as a reactivity series, students. Blue copper sulfate, a blue copper sulfate solution converted into colorless because zinc sulfate is formed. Yes, zinc is more reactive than copper. So copper will displaces from its compound called copper sulfate. So colorless solution will converted, a blue color of copper sulfate convert into colorless because there forms zinc solution, that is zinc sulfate. Okay.